One day, Thomas was waiting at the junction when a bus came into the yard. "Hello," said Thomas. "Who are you?" "I'm Bertie," said the bus. "Who are you?" "I am Thomas. I run this branch line." Bertie laughed. "Oh, I remember now," he said. "You were stuck in the snow. I had to take your passengers. Then Terence the tractor had to pull you out. I've come to help you with your passengers today." "Help me," said Thomas crossly. "I can go faster than you," he said, going bluer than ever and letting off steam. "You can't," said Bertie. "I can," huffed Thomas. "I'll race you," said Bertie. Their drivers agreed to the race. "Are you ready?" "Go!" And they were off. It always took Thomas a little while to build up speed, so Bertie quickly drew in front. Thomas was running well, but he did not hurry. "Why don't you go fast? Why don't you go fast?" called Annie and Clarabel, who were running along behind. "Wait and see, wait and see," hissed Thomas. "He's a long way ahead, a long way ahead," they cried anxiously. But Thomas didn't mind. He had remembered the level crossing. There was Bertie fuming at the crossing gate while they sailed gaily through. "Goodbye, Bertie," called Thomas. After that, the road left the railway and went through a village. They couldn't see Bertie anymore. Before long, they had to stop at a station to let off passengers. "Quickly, please," called Thomas. Everybody got out quickly. The guard blew his whistle and off they went again. "Come along, come along," sang Thomas. We're coming along," said Annie and Clarabel. Thomas looked straight ahead and whistled in horror. There was Bertie crossing the bridge over the railway, tooting triumphantly on his horn. "Oh, dearie me! Oh, dearie me!" groaned Thomas. "Steady, Thomas," said Thomas's driver. "We'll beat Bertie yet." Annie and Clarabel joined in. "We'll beat Bertie yet, we'll beat Bertie yet," they sang. "We'll do it, we'll do it," puffed Thomas bravely. "Oh, bother! There's a station." As Thomas stopped at the station, he heard Bertie tooting loudly. "Goodbye, Thomas. You must be tired," called Bertie as he raced by. "Sorry, I can't stop. We buses have to work, you know. Goodbye." "Oh, dear," thought Thomas. "We've lost." But he felt better after a drink. Then the signal dropped to show that the line was clear and they were off again. As they rumbled over the bridge, they saw Bertie waiting at the traffic light. When the lights turned green, Bertie started with a roar and chased on after Thomas again. Road and railway ran up the valley side by side. By now, Thomas had reached his full speed. Bertie tried hard, but Thomas was too fast. On and on they raced. Excited passengers cheered and shouted across the valley as Thomas whistled triumphantly and plunged into the tunnel, leaving Bertie toiling far behind. "We've done it! We've done it!" chanted Annie and Clarabel happily as they whooshed into the last station. Everybody was there to give Thomas three cheers for winning the race. They all gave Bertie a big welcome too. "Well done, Thomas," said Bertie. "That was fun. But to beat you over that hill, I should have had to grow wings and be an aeroplane." Now Thomas and Bertie keep each other very busy. Bertie finds people in the villages who want to go by train and takes them to Thomas, while Thomas brings people to the station for Bertie to take home. Bertie and Thomas often talk about their race, but Bertie's passengers don't like being bounced like peas in a frying pan. The fat controller has warned Thomas not to race at dangerous speed. So although Thomas and Bertie would like to have another race, I don't think they ever will. Do you?
We'll be right back.